you know, you can't make this stuff up. My name remains Martin Hyde. I love coming down here. There's nothing much on TV. This is a lot more fun. You know, the idea of changing the date of our city elections was to widen voter participation, creating a more representative city commission. The turnout in yesterday's primary was, though, under 30%, for lots of reasons, meaning that 7 out of 10 eligible city voters didn't vote for any of the candidates, contrary to the hooting and hollering and talking about winning from Liz Alpert earlier. The winning candidate, who was not Liz Alpert, was Terry Turner, won 30% of the 30% that voted. So it's practically speaking, less than 11% of those that could have affirmed him as their definitive choice did. I don't think this was the intention, but the outcome of the primary in District 2 was that with 6 candidates and low Republican turnout, nonpartisan notwithstanding, the 2 Democrats prevailed, leaving the 70% that didn't vote, and in particular the 40% who are registered Republicans, in particular, with no real choice in the general election. Herbert Hoover, FDR, Eisenhower, and Nixon all won presidential primaries as write-in candidates. Strong Thurmond in 1954 and more recently Lisa Murkowski in Alaska won seats in the U.S. Senate as write-in candidates. In 2020, the city of Sarasota, we'll have a drum roll here, is going to have a write-in option for District 2 of the city in the general election for those voters that care enough to write in the name of the candidate of their choice. I know that all of you believe in democracy, and I know, therefore, you will all welcome the opportunity to let our citizens make their choices based not on the impossible one of between a rock and a hard place, but between those that would defund our police or candidates who believe in the President of the United States, Donald J. Trump. They want an option who believes in the freedom of our people to live their lives free from wearing muzzles, real or figurative, on a daily basis. Sarasota wants and deserves a free choice, not one contrived by the nuances of mutually assured destruction which crowded primaries can create. As of 7:30 last night, I was done with this nonsense. But by this morning, my email was full of voters upset and who feel underrepresented. And I have agreed to help them have their choice on November the 3rd.